Salvete omnes. Today we're looking at, or I'll be talking about, Romulus the King, the last lecture on the life of Romulus. Now we're going to start off here with a picture of Romulus with Titus Tatius, the king of the Sabines. And we left off, remember, where the Sabines had waged a war against the Romans to get back the Sabine women under Titus Tatius's leadership. And the war was stopped by the Sabine women who came between the two military forces as they were fighting and stopped the fight. And Titus, Tatius, and Romulus later became joint rulers of the new state. And some other things to lead off with this. So there was peace and order brought because of the peace made by Romulus and Titus, Tatius. The swamp where Metis Curtius fell off his horse was named Curtius's Lake. So remember, in the battle, there was two heroes fighting for either side. Metis Curtius was a Sabine hero, and he supposedly fell off his horse in the middle of the forum where there was a big marshy lake area. And the area and that lake later became known as Locus Curtius. Romulus then honored the Sabine women by dividing the population city into 30 groups or 30 wards and named the wards after the Sabine women. Romulus also created three centuries of knights, so three like squadrons of knights, which would be like cavalry squadrons or cavalry companies. And one was named the Ramnenses after Romulus. Supposedly the other one was named Titiennes after Tatius. And another one was named Lucrares, named after who we don't know. And Romulus and Tatius ruled jointly as two kings. But there could be only one, as a wise person once said. Some years later, kingsmen of Tatius offered violence to some Laurentian ambassadors. So these are ambassadors from the city of Laurentium. The Laurentian wanted justice for the violation of international laws. But Tatius allowed blood ties to influence his decision. Because these were relatives, he let them off. Tatius was then killed in a riot in Lavinium. This left Romulus as sole ruler. Romulus refused to go to war with Lavinium because he felt Tatius got what he deserved. All right, now Romulus is the sole king, but there were still some problems with Rome and the people around Rome. Soon the Romans were under attack by the people of Fidenae, who were alarmed by the rapid growth of Rome. They raided the countryside between the two towns, and Romulus had to act quick, for the enemy was so close. Romulus set an ambush for the army of Fidenae. Romulus sent a small force to the gates of Fidenae while the rest of his army hid on the sides in thick brush. The forces of Fidenae easily handled the small force of the Romans, and as the small force retreated, the forces of Fidenae rushed after them in pursuit. Then the Romans, hiding in ambush, were able to outflank the enemies and easily defeated them. Now, they also had trouble with the town of Veii, which was one of the Etruscan towns near Rome. And they were also alarmed by the growth of Rome. They sent disorganized raiding parties into Rome and quickly headed back to their home city with their loot. Romulus responded by sending an army to Veii. The people of Veii, not wanting to be held up by a long siege, came out and fought. Romulus, with no plan but by pure strength and experience of his troops, defeated the forces of Veii. The people of Veii made a peace with Rome and made a 100-year truce. By this point, everyone felt that Romulus was divine because of both his military and political achievements, and they considered him divine after his death. Romulus displayed vigor, recovering his ancestral throne and bringing strength to Rome in both the arts of peace and war. He enjoyed untroubled tranquility for the next 40 years. I'm sure this is all true. He was loved by the common people, and especially the army, more than he was loved by the Senate. He also maintained a personal armed guard called the Celeres, the Swift. One day, Romulus is out with his troops on the Campus Martius, and a storm burst that enveloped Romulus so that no one could see him And then with violent thunder, he was never seen again. So a giant cloud came down, engulfed where he was sitting there as he was looking at the troops. And then when the cloud disappeared with the thunder, he was gone. People freaked out. Some say that Romulus is taken up to heaven in a whirlwind. Others says he was torn apart by senators. And the body was then hidden. However, Julius Proculus, an honored man for his wisdom, called the commoners by saying, "The father of the city appeared to him before daybreak and announced he was now immortal and in heaven." And go ahead, he said a little bit further. I'll go ahead and read to you what he said. He said, "Romans," he said, "Romulus, the father of the city, suddenly descending from heaven, appeared to me this day at daybreak. While I stood covered with awe and filled with a religious dread, beseeching him to allow me to see him face to face, he said, 'Go tell the Romans, the gods so will, that my Rome should become the capital of the world. Therefore, let them cultivate the art of war, and let them know, and hand down to prosperity, that no human power shall be able to withstand the Roman arms.' Having said this, he just ascended up to heaven." And there we go. And so with Julius Proculus saying this, everyone believed that he had become a god and that Rome had a destiny to become capital of the world. And there we go. All right. Volite omnes, lingua latina est vita.